Okay, assalamu alaikum and very good morning to all. Okay, today we will continue our next lecture on the noise and vibrations. Okay, this is lecture number 6, where we already go to another model, which is a 2 degree of freedom models. Okay, before this, we have already completed all the necessary items on a single degree of freedoms. And also you have been given 3 assessment here. Okay, and now for today, week 4, we are continuing on the 2 degree of freedoms. It is also known as a multi degree of freedom because it's over than 1 degree of freedom, so it's also considered as multi degree of freedoms. Okay, if you can understand how to derive this 2 degree of freedom system, means that you can also know how to derive a more degree of freedom, which is 3, 4 and others lah. Okay, so basically in this lecture is in the free vibration. Okay, there's no force, excitation force, and where you can basically calculate the natural frequency and plot your mode shapes. Okay, and also in this lecture you introduced to the frequency response function. Okay, which is basically the similar plots that you have been done before in the single degree of freedoms. Okay, so as an overview, okay, we have now to do on the free vibration of 2 degree of freedoms, and also at the end you will know how to calculate the natural frequencies and also the mode shapes. Okay, this is example of the frequency response function where we have 2 natural frequency, the first peak and the second peaks, where the first one is represent the first natural frequency and the second one is represent the second natural frequency of the system. Okay, okay, so what is the 2 degree freedoms? Okay, in the analysis of 2 degree freedom system, it's allow for the understanding of multi degree freedom system, but it's more reduced complexity lah. Okay, means that it's only 2 degree of freedom, it can basically the problem can be 3, 4, or 5 degree of freedoms based on the model. Okay, so many systems have more than 1 degree of freedom system. Okay, so what you have learned before is actually all the simplified model. Okay, if we can model it to the simplest one, then it's better lah for calculation and everything. But in some cases it cannot be simplified to 1 degree of freedom, and at least it might have a 2 degree of freedom system. So basically what you have learned before, what is degree of freedom? Is a minimum number of coordinates to specify the position of the system. Mean that, okay, the number of degree of freedom is equal to the number of mass and the number of possible multiplied by the number of possible motions of each of the mass. Okay, okay, so we see in this one, okay, for examples, okay, we have here, okay, this model, right? Okay, so this is considered, all the model is considered as a 2 degree of freedom system. Okay, so for this one we have one mass here and multiplied by one motions, and this one also one mass multiplied by one motion, so we plus here so that we have a 2 degree of freedoms. Okay, for this one, for example, this is only one mass, but it has the 2 motions, so it's multiplied by 2, it's also considered as a 2 degree of freedoms. So same goes to here, where there's a theta motions, okay, rotational, and also the vertical vibrations. Okay, so that is also considered as a 2 degree of freedom system. Okay, so for this one is the same as this. Okay, you see the motion is only on the rotational, and it have 2 mass and 2 motions. Okay, so that's what you have to know, and so that you can decide from the problems what is the degree of freedom of the system. Okay, okay, so basically this is the step by step, okay, where you have to follow to determine the solution lah for the 2 degree of freedom system. Okay, the first one is you have to derive the equation of motion. Okay, so this is basically you already know on the single degree of freedom system, but for this one you have to shown in term of metric form, because it have a to equations. Okay, and the step two where you have the same method, we have a simple harmonic motion. Okay, the trial function for this free vibration is given as this. Okay, x t equal to x exponential I omega t, and then after that you can have a solution to get the natural frequency lah, which is the omega. So for this case, we have a 2 omega, which is omega 1 and omega 2, where it represents the first and second natural frequency. And finally, by replacing the omega value into the equations, so that you can have the mode shape lah, which is represented by x, okay, the movement. Okay, so next, okay, this is considered as 2 degree of freedoms, okay, as a free vibration, which is a free undamped vibration. Okay, so for the 2 degree freedom, we for the derivation, we only consider as a undamped system lah, because for the damped system is quite complicated. Okay, to derive then it can be done also lah, but for the syllabus is we can only do the derivation for without the damping lah. Okay, so you have two mass here, okay, two stiffness and two movement, okay. Okay, so as usual, okay, maybe I can show you a bit. Is a similar method as shown before this. Okay, for this case, you have a mass number 2, mass number 1, okay, K2, K1. x1 t x2 t. Okay, so as usual, you this one you have to divide by 2 lah. Okay, so for the mass, this is positive and negative. Okay, so the same one, positive, okay, so negative. So for the upper part, okay, we have a this for the above part, we have no connection, so that is 0 lah. Okay, so for the below part, we have a K2, okay, where is a below part minus K2. So assume that X1 is bigger than X2, X2 is bigger than X1, so X2 minus X1. Okay, so for the M1, we have a upper part, we have the K2 now, the connection. K2 is at the above part, so it's a plus, okay, X2 minus X1. Okay, so for the below part, we only have a minus K1 X1. Okay, so this is the each for the each of the mass lah. Okay, so now we have the mass 1. For the mass 1 equation, total F equal to MA. So for the total force, we only have a minus K2, okay, X2 minus X1 is equal to M2 X2 double dot. Okay, this is equation number 1. Okay, and for the M2, we have a total force, we have a minus K1 X1 plus K2 X2 minus X1, okay, equal to M1 X1 double dots. Okay, so this is basically two equation lah. Okay, after that you can simplify it. Okay, arrange it by numbers and the mass lah. Okay, mass and stiffness. So we confirm back here the mass number 1 here. This is the mass number 2. This is mass number 1. Okay, so for the mass number 1 here, we have a minus K1 X1 plus K2, okay, X2 minus X1. Go to M1 X1 double dot. And for this one, mass number 2 here, we have minus K2, okay, X2 minus X1, okay, equal to M2 X2 double dot. Okay, so basically, this is the M2 lah previously. Okay, this is M1. Okay, so that is how you can derive it. Okay, so the same method, if there another degree of freedom up here, Okay, then you can do the same method lah. Okay, this is for the 2 degree of freedoms. Okay, so next one. Okay, so we can rearrange back. Okay, for the equation number one, for mass number one here. Okay, you can arrange back to get in this form. Okay, and also for the equation number two. Okay, you can arrange back to get in this form. Okay, so basically, what I want to emphasize here is that to transform in a metric form, you have to arrange it. The rule of thumb is you have to arrange it by the mass damping stiffness, which the element number 1, 2, or 3. Yeah, this is based on the degree of freedom. So for this one, we don't have C, so we arrange M and K. So this one M, K, okay, and the arrangement must be the motion X must be arranged by numbers of 1, 2, 3. So you can see here 1, 1, 2. Okay, so for the mass number 2, okay, also same goes, you arrange because this is not x1 double dot, so x2 lah. Okay, so for the x, for the k, you have x1 and x2, same again, you must arrange by 1 and 2 because this is easiest for you to transform into the metric form later on. Okay. Okay, so we can see here the next slide is on the how it can transfer to the metric form. Okay, so now, okay, so you arrange it by this x1 and x2 double dot, so you can transfer it. Okay, you can directly insert lah. This is m1 here for the equation number 1 and equation number 2 lah. So for the equation number 1, there is only m1 lah. m2, there is 0 m2. For equation number 2, 0 m1. Okay, and it's only have m2 here. Okay, so for the k element, so you have arranged for x1 and x2 here. So this is for the x1, x2, okay, and for the second equation, same goes x1, x2, so minus k2 here and k plus k2 here. So this transfer the for the x equal to 0, okay, because of free variation. Okay, so this complete your first step lah, okay? The first step already complete in this form, okay? Now, what you have to do next, okay? Okay, so you can represent it lah in terms of this metric form. Basically, this is the detail lah, the mass metric, stiffness, acceleration, and the displacement matrix, okay? Okay, so basically the 2 degree of freedom system must have 2 equation of motion. Okay, this is you have my alert lah. If you decide your system is 2 degree of freedom, it must have a 2 equation like this. Okay, equation number 1 and equation number 2. It must have 2 natural frequency. Okay, later on you will calculate, you will get omega 1 and omega 2. Equation are coupled. Okay, which is a free variation equal to 0 lah. Okay, this is example where you can see the system. Okay, it's actually coupled by this connection. Okay, K1 and K2. So when you arrange the matrix, this must fulfill lah all the space here. But this is the example where there's no the equation is not coupled. Okay, because the mass is connected by the stiffness or the spring. Okay, and both equation must have in term of x1 and x2. Okay, so you can check back. Okay, both equation have the x1 and x2. Okay, if one mass move, okay, the others will follow lah. Okay, because it's a couple system. Okay, so the next step is on the second one where you place the trial function. Okay, so we have the given the trial function xt, so you differentiate it. Okay, you can get the velocity and acceleration, but since this is no damping, so we only consider x and x double dot. Okay, so you can insert to the equation previously. Okay, so in the matrix, okay, you have the matrix and then you rearrange back, okay, so you can be in this form, okay, where this form you can use a characteristic equation, okay, as usual to determine previously in the single degree freedom free damped variation, you determine the lambda, okay. This one also the same one lah. This lambda is later on you can relate with your omega, okay. We show in detail after this, okay. From this you can determine the by given the value of k and mass for all this system, okay. For the m2, m1, k1 and k2 is given, so that you can calculate the omega. Then finally after get the value of omega, okay, you can replace the omega here because you already know the value of omega 1, omega 2, k1, k2 and m1 m2, so that you can find the x1 and x2. So this is represent the mode shapes later on, eh. Okay, so we can see in detail here. Okay, this basically how the mode shape is. Okay, basically actually you have learned before in the EML 331 last semester on the experimental mode analysis, where you of the beam, if you still remember, you can get the first, second and third modes and then frequency of the beams, which mean that you can get also in terms of bending or torsional modes, okay. So this is a example of the torsional modes, okay. So the mode shape is a specific pattern of vibration executed by a mechanical system at specific frequency lah. So for example, this happened at the first natural frequency of the first torsional mode, for example at 10 hertz. This is basically how it move lah. So if you can imagine when the ship is going through the sea and then the sea wave is excited, okay, at the 10 hertz, and this is basically how the ship will be vibrates, okay. So it's a resonance, basically when the excitation from the wave is equal to this natural frequency and this mode shape, this will be dangerous, is because it's in the resonance phenomena, okay. Okay, so this is how we can go in detail, okay. Maybe I can go back to this slide. Okay, so the given mass here, okay, we have the k1, okay, k2, m1 and m2. So now the problem has give you the value, okay. So you need to derive and get the natural frequency, okay. So this is the step one. Before this you get the matrix, okay, m x k x k, still remember, okay. So from this you replace all this with the simple harmonic motion or trial functions, okay. Because we have x1 and x2 here, so that you must have a multiples trial function lah, okay. But this is different, it's just the numbers 1 and 2, okay. So from this you replace it, okay, you replace it the value in x double dot and x here, okay, so that you can have a solution after this, okay. So you can make a simplifications, okay. Now we have this, okay, we can move the omega to outside, so we remain here the x and x here. Then of course after that we can still simplify it, okay, because this x1 and x2 is the same for both, so you can simplify, move it outside, okay. We have outside of omega the power of 2 minus omega of 2 and x1 and x2. So now you can have the solution lah, okay. This is basically the metric what you have learned in calculus and also during your matriculation or SPM, where we can do a simple solution here lah. Okay, 9 multiplied by omega the power of 2, we have a minus plus 27, same goes to others location space also, okay. So from this Okay, thus we have two homogeneous equations, okay, one and two, which are two unknowns, which is omega 2 lah, okay, which is omega 1 and omega 2. Now we have two unknowns, okay. For non-trivial solution, we require that the determinant to be zero, okay, where, okay, we have a dissolution lah, okay, basically, okay, so this you can have a solution, okay, this multiply, and this one is multiplied by this, minus 3 is multiplied by minus 3 is 9 lah, okay. So you have this of this solution lah, okay. Okay, now you can have a solution of this, okay. If you simplify it, okay, you can have this in the final form lah, okay, the character's equation. So from this, you can replace it, okay, where we replace lambda is equal to omega power of 2, because we want make it a more simplified form, okay, because later on we can, after we get the lambda, we can convert it to the omega lah, okay, it's no problem for that. This is because we have want to reduce the power of 4 to 2, okay. So from this, as usual, you have this equation characteristic, okay. From this you have a value is equal to 1, b equal to minus 6, and c equal to 8, okay. Okay, so from this you can replace it, okay, and finally you can get the value of lambda 1 and lambda 2 is 4 and 2, okay, but later on this is not the final value yet, because you have to convert it to omega. Then after you convert it to omega, then you can decide which one is omega 1 and omega 2. So basically, the first omega should be the lowest value lah. For this case, is a minus 2 radian per second for omega 1, and omega 2 is 2 radian per second. Okay, this is because when you plot the graph, okay, for example, you plot the graph. So when you plot the graph, okay, of frequency response function, so you will get the first natural frequency and then the second. Then, so the omega 1 and omega 2, so omega 1 should be the lowest value lah, okay, because it's smaller than this omega 2, okay. So from this, you already get the natural frequency. So the step number 3 is now completed lah, okay. Okay, then after that, okay, the next step is to find the mode shapes, okay, the mode shapes of the system. This is done by substituting the natural frequency into the equation, okay, by substituting omega with the value of omega 1, then you will get the mode shape number 1 lah, which is x1, okay, and we assume that if x1 move by 1 cm, for example, then we can solve the x2 also lah. Okay, this we get the same answer lah, either for the both metric equation. So you can see here the solutions. Okay, okay. So let's say we replace this matrix. Okay, we refer back to equation number 50. You replace omega 1 equal to square root of 2. Okay, and then you can only use either one lah. Take either one because both is the same lah, okay, we'll get the same answer. Okay, for example, we take okay, for the first example I show you both, okay, the 9x1 minus by minus 3, okay, and this one is here, okay. So then when you assume that x1 is equal to 1, okay. Okay, so that you can get the value of x2 lah, okay. Same goes here, you can still get the same value, which is x2 is equal to 3x1. Okay, this is the first mode of the system. Okay, this means when the system oscillate at its first natural frequency, the system will oscillate in this mode lah. For example, which x1 is moved by 1 cm, and then we know that x2 will move by 3 cm. Okay, Okay, to find the second modes shape, we must use the second natural frequency lah. Okay, so maybe I think I can show you how you can draw it. Okay, the mode shapes in okay, so maybe this one is previously M1. Okay. K1. Okay, this is K2, M2. Okay. So let's say we this one, okay. We know that okay. If we consider this is a 1 cm, X1, okay. And this is 3 cm. Okay, so for the first modes, okay, let's say this is 0. Okay, sorry, this actually should be a linear one, the straight line. Okay, so if the x1 if moved by 1 cm, and the x2 will move by 3 cm. Okay, this is the first mode lah. Okay, you can see the movement. Okay. Is a linear movement lah, okay. Okay, so let's see the second mode shapes. Okay, the second mode shape, we have a omega 2 equal to 2 radian second lah, okay, when we replace it. So let's say we just take the first one, okay. So we have a solution of x2 equal to minus 3x1. So we know that when the x1 is moved by 1 cm, so that the x2 will move by minus 3 cm. Okay. So for the mode shape number two, okay, maybe I can draw you another colors here. Okay, so for the this one minus 3 cm. Okay, so for the mode shape number two, okay, when the x1 is moved by 1 cm, okay. Is still the same here, okay. And the x2 will move minus 3 cm, okay. Minus 3 cm, okay. It's move minus 3 cm. So the you can see the on the maroon one is the first mode shapes, okay. It's just a movement like this, but for the second mode shape is a x1 and x2 is move in the different is a opposite directions, okay. This is what we call the first bending modes and the second bending modes. Okay, I think you are already familiar with all the bending during the strain of material. Okay, you have learned what is bending. So this is basically how the system is vibrate at the first and the second bending. Okay, this is also you already also determined in your previously semester one lab. Okay. Okay. So finally, actually, you can represent the mode shape number one. Okay, is a x1 equal to 1 3, and x2 to 1 minus 3. So this is represent the maroon one, and this one is represent the blue one. Okay. Okay. So the next is. Sorry. Okay. Okay, so this slide. So this is the other way lah. But I think the what I've shown you is better for you to understand lah how it different the movement. Okay, this is the same one when it's move at x1, 1 cm, the m2 will follow in the same direction which 3 cm. But for the mode number two, when the x1 is moved by 1 cm, this is moved by minus 3 cm. Okay, so this is the animation. Okay, the mode one, you can see when the mass move, the mass number two will also goes to the same direction. But for the mode number two, mass number one and mass number two move in the opposite direction. Okay. Okay, so basically natural frequency are also known as eigenvalues. Okay. And mode shapes sometimes are called as eigenvectors. Okay, so what I have explained to you previously, okay, so that's we have this frequency response function. Okay, we have our first natural frequency omega 1, omega 2, actually it's represented here, omega 1 and omega 2. Okay, and then each of these mode shapes omega 1 is represent the this mode shape lah, okay, and omega 2 is represent this mode shapes, the blue one, okay. Okay, so that's how you can also plot the frequency response functions. Okay. Okay, so let's see these examples. Okay. So we have the consider that on the left we have a building of two tower buildings. Okay. The floor is rigid compared to vertical columns, but can oscillate horizontally. Okay. Given the stiffness, the bending stiffness EI, okay, is a 45 multiplied by 10 the power of 3 kilonewton meter power of 2. The stiffness for each column is given by this equation lah. Okay, so you have to determine firstly you have to transform lah from this physical, how you can transform it to the free body diagram. Okay, and then later on you can calculate, you can make it a simplified form. Okay, because this has a K1, K2, K3, and K4. Before this, you already learned on the stiffness equivalent. This is parallel, so that's, you can transform it to this form, okay, by plus it lah, K1 plus K2 and K3 plus K4, you can transform it to this one, okay. So, any of the system that have a complicated stiffness, you can always simplify it in this 2 degree of form lah, okay, but using, must consider the stiffness equivalent equations lah, okay. Okay, so this is the step, the same step, you must first transform is the free body diagram, derive equation of motions, calculate the natural frequencies and also the mode shapes. Okay, you can see the solution here. Okay, so this is what I have told you lah, okay, where we have a K1 and K2. Okay, it's a 2K lah, okay, 2K represent for each of these stiffness, okay, because this, we have a 2K, 2 beam here, okay, and of course you have to get a solution for the stiffness value first lah, okay, so the given value here, the bending stiffness multiply by 12 and divide by the height, okay, of the beam, which is 3 meter for each of the floor. Okay, so you actually the value of stiffness is same lah for the K1 and K2. The difference is only the mass. Okay, the given 3 ton and 5 ton for the M1 and M2. So the same solution, you have the equation of motion. Okay, and then you transform into metric forms. Okay, until you get the characteristic equation here. And then you replace, you can calculate the omega 1 and omega 2. After that, after get the omega 1 and omega 2, you can replace the equation and get the mode shapes. Okay, this is the similar method that has been shown before, but just only with different values and case study lah. Okay. Okay, so same goes to here. Okay, this is the another system. Okay, 2 degree of freedoms. Okay. So basically, this is quite different because you have a tree spring. Okay, basically your system is until here, but this is connected to the fixed upper base also, and you also have a stiffness K3. So this you can basically you can try it later on. Okay, how the equation of motion is a little bit different because it have the another element of K3. Okay, it's not a and it have a fixed base at the upper and lower sides here. Okay, so for this you can try later on, you can derive the equation of motion. Okay, and then you can estimate the natural frequency. You can choose your own M1, M2, K1, K2 and K3 values, it depend on you. Okay, calculate the mode shapes. Okay, draw the free body diagram, and finally if the question answer asks you if the first natural frequency amplitude is larger than the second natural frequency, plot the FRF graph. So this one can be done, okay, like what I have shown you before. Okay, so if you have a this is considered function, this is amplitude and this is frequency. So let's say the first natural frequency amplitude is larger than second, then you can draw the this like this one lah, which is this is omega 1, omega 2, and this is amplitude number 1, amplitude number 2, where the A1 is bigger than A2. Okay. Okay, so I think that's all for the today class. Okay, thank you for listening. Okay.